Okay guys, how's she going today? So, it's a Monday, and the sun just finally popped out after fucking 3 or 4 days of fucking continuous rain, you could say. Ooh, this is soft as mushy. So that means the car's gonna probably sink right into that. But anyways, my basement is flooded. Oh, I forgot the freaking shop tails. Son of a bitch. But anyways, my basement is flooded. I've already moved about 80 gallons of water in probably just half an hour. My pump comes on about every 20 seconds. So the ground's just soaked. So, but yeah, I'm gonna try to maybe get the ion out. I forgot shop towels. I got the battery already in, but I don't have it hooked up. This piece of pipe here is holding up this floor thing. There's your spare donut. I never really secure the battery in there, you know, because I'm never driving it anywhere. So just the weight of the battery itself stays in there. I don't bother. I don't know what that thing does, but I don't bother. I think it actually goes to that bolt. I don't bother ever making sure that stays in there. Found some kind of a bolt. I mean, that's always been in the bottom of that damn car. Lots of other freaking junk. I'm not even sure what the hell that's supposed to go to. I don't think I don't even know if that's supposed to belong in here. So much fucking junk, and then you got your spare donut. I don't think that's even got air in it. Oh, it still does. Still got the original jack that's never been used. I have to check oil. I gotta check the oil level. Dipstick's just down in there. I'm gonna try to maybe blow some of this crap off. There's a big old dent in the roof there too. But anyways, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to order probably not on, well, it'll be next month maybe. Not on payday though. I'm thinking my YouTube money should come in, hopefully by then. So I'm going to buy a cover for this car. I think they're about 20, 30 bucks a piece. It's only a single layer. You can get a double and a triple layer, you know, if you want that extra bit of protection. I just want to keep some of the crap off, so one should be fine. Just to protect the car. And I'm actually going to probably try to maybe clean this car off too while it's sitting outside and running. I gotta make sure that I still have oil in this thing before I even start it. And I forgot my shop towels. But if it did leak all the oil out, I think it would be all over the floor. I gotta take my heater in too at some point. I want to get the car out. I want to get this tiller moved back because I'm going to probably bring in my snow plow. And then I'm probably going to get the John Deere going. I don't know if I'm going to get the John Deere going today or not. My grass is actually greening up pretty good now. If we continue to keep getting this nice weather now, my grass should actually be almost due for a mowing. Another week or two. And plus another thing too is I like to get ready ahead of time. Some people like to do stuff last minute, which is what my uncle does. I find it easier just to do stuff ahead of time. Get it running. Get it ready. The only thing I'll have to do is sharpen the blades on it one of these days before I actually do mow. But yeah, let me go and get my shop towels because I'm gonna have to check the oil level, and then I'll hook the battery up. And yeah, and actually the battery here actually went a couple of months without being on the charger or on the tender because the cats unplugged it, because it's got a quick connect in the middle of the wiring, so they broke it free, and I just never bothered to went down there and fix it. So when it went a couple of months, but I hooked it back up probably about a couple of months ago, and it was fine. I think this battery could literally sit in my basement all winter and it would never drain itself because it never needs to be charged. So but yeah, give me 1 minute, guys. I'm gonna go grab some trap towels and I will be right. Yeah, and another thing too, I got the trap towels. The west side of my yard is literally underwater, and I'm out of breath because I just kept freaking running back and forth. Like, I forget multiple things. I go grab one, then I realize, oh, I forgot the other shit. So I run back again. I ran in the house to grab the GoPro and the battery and something else. But I forgot to grab shop towels, so I had to run back and get those. And I shouldn't need any special tools. I should have enough wrenches here, I think, to hook my battery up. You know, either way you think about it. Well, I was thinking that I should have backed this car in, because I could have gotten to the motor real easy. But then I'm thinking, but then I never would have been able to get to the battery very well. Fuck, either way you lose. You know, either way you lose, boys. Either way you freaking lose. I hate losing. But oh well. Of course, you can't fit your fat ass in here and do anything, because being a fat ass at all, you know. Nice and black and gooey. That's always dandy as friggin' hell. Hell. Now I wish that they would have used this kind of a dipstick on Big Red, a metal one. They did it on the John Deere, but for some reason they didn't do it on Big Red. They decided to make it a plastic one, and I've heard a couple times of them breaking. Just don't put them on so freaking tight, then they won't break. Then right, put them on tight enough that they won't, you know, break themselves loose, but tight enough that, you know, they won't seize. Now, since I'm blind as a mole, I can't find the thingy for this now. I don't know where to go now. More flakes. Another thing. Low light situations, never good. Ah, there it is. Should've grabbed my work light, I guess, but I didn't think to grab my work light. Shouldn't freaking need it anyway, right? Stay up there, phone. So we'll go back in. Or not. There we go. All the way in. Let it sit for a second. We'll pull it back out. And that should give me my reading. And as far as I can tell, we are over full. But we're not that full this time. It's up, it's about here. About here-ish. If you can see that. Before, it used to be way up here. And that's because the mortar's getting moisture in it. Probably because of the crack. I wouldn't doubt it if there's a crack in the block, because why the hell else is it pissing oil then? Unless I didn't put a seal on all the way, that could always be another thing too. I didn't put something back together, right? Because I figured the motor was junk. But you know what? We need a pretty functional motor, you know, to get us places. You know, places. Yeah, back there. That's about it. freaking cobwebs everywhere, and freaking, I'm surprised the damn bee nest hasn't moved in here yet. Okay, well, the motor checks out. I'm not going to bother checking the air filter because it's over on that side, and I checked it last year, and it was clean, so. This car's never really seen much of dirty or dusty roads. I mean, it's seen a few, but not enough to, clog a filter. Now, I could use an open or an adjustable wrench, but I like these here solid fixed ones, these stupid things. Just because. Now, you guys are not going to be able to see me do this, so I can put you guys down there, I guess. But I just got to find out what size of bolt we're dealing with. Now, these bolts don't come out, do they? No, they don't. So we're going to take our first guess and say it's a 3/8. And the big head's in the way, of course. No, that's actually too big. Well, sure, the hell can't be a 5/16. Or is it? Holy fuck, it's a 5/16? That's kind of tiny. It's kind of tiny for that size of battery, but whatever. So, it's supposed to be a certain way that you're supposed to do these. I think it's probably negative first and then positive first. I don't know. I usually just kind of pick whatever which one. Because I don't think it matters. To be honest with you, I don't think it matters a heck of a lot. Now, I think as long as the negative is not touching, which is not touching anything metal, it shouldn't ground out. But if my wrench was to touch something metal, it would arc out. And I've done that to the John Deere a couple times. I forgot that there was a shroud there for the muffler. And then when I was going to put battery wire back on, this made contact, sparked. Literally thought I was going to blow up and die. But I guess I didn't. And did you see how the negative arced? I don't know if you've seen that or not, but the negative one arced. So maybe you're supposed to go negative first, then positive. I heard it somewhere, but I forget. So I don't think it really matters. I'm not 100% sure. I really should look into that. But we're getting her now. As long as I'm not touching anything wet, I'm going to get a ranger coming. And I don't really feel like being shocked. No, this probably won't help me much. But got a black ranger coming. Now, this glove's not made out of rubber, so it's probably not going to do me any good, but I can get a better grip with a wrench, too, this way. So, there's supposed to be a put this on nice and tight. This wire here, the negative, runs actually right down to the corner of the battery, which I'll show you. Make sure these are nice and good. Okay, then I'm going to put this cover on. A lot of dumbasses don't put the cover back on. I really don't see a point for this anyway, because the battery never gets wet anyway. But we'll do it anyway. Just because we said so. And because I'm the boss, I guess. I don't fucking know. Does it matter? Probably does, but who the fuck cares? So we should have power now. Running throughout this whole entire vehicle. So we'll get get these wrenches out of here now. And I'm not going to secure that battery in place because I'm not driving it. So I see no point. Get you guys back out of there. Hey, how you guys doing? Get my redneck holder out. Let that fall. There's one thing I would like to do one day when I get this car up and running. Is I'm going to leave the trunk popped. Just in case we should have any electrical problems and I can disconnect the battery. Is this carpet's been stained. I don't know if that comes out or not. But I don't know if they make a replacement piece for that. See how it's just got like plywood here and then this foam over it. I wonder if they make a whole new section. I don't know if anything could actually take that stain out or not. I don't know what could take it out. Besides just getting a whole new piece and burning the old one, but... Now there's a trick. That Crazy JD Kid was telling me about for these doors when they auto lock. I guess I can deactivate that. Okay. Our gauge has moved. I know the trunk's opened. Now we're supposed to hold this for a few seconds, I believe. Beeps twice. That means that should actually stay. I believe when he says when it beeps twice, it's been deactivated. So we are going to get this cold cranking and see if we blow it up or not. This is a very tough ion. Very tough. I love this fucking car. This thing just started like it was running yesterday. It's incredible. Oh, but I got my hoses in the way. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my hoses out of here. This hose has been damaged, but mother still seems to be able to use it. This one here is for my pump. So I don't wanna run this one over. And that one there that's hanging on the walls is no good anyway because it leaks. So. See those people walking over at that house? Those people live in the trees. They got plans as well. I got plans as well. So, and it's not that smoky. I'm really surprised. I thought she'd be smoking like a crazy car, but I don't know. So, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna move it. I know the hood's open, I know the trunk's open, car. I know. But we're not going that far. I had a problem. Hopefully, that. Well, if the trunk cleared, the hood should clear. I don't want to bend my rod, so I gotta be careful what I'm doing here. Come on, baby. Oh yeah, I think we're gonna be okay. Yeah, I think we should be okay. I tell you one thing, if the Farmall A can run like this fucking car, I'd be amazed. And the door is still auto-locked. Well, I'm gonna roll this window down. That should have actually, or was it the other way you're supposed to do that? I don't remember, it locked. I'm probably doing it the wrong way. But we got all summer to figure out with it anyway. I'm not gonna worry about it too much. So, I No, it's just been leaking. She's definitely a leaker. But since it's running, I think I'm going to get my air compressor going, and I'm going to blow out the leaves and crap out of it quick. And it does have fuel stabilizer in it too, so the fuel should be okay. Thank you.